could potentially happen is, this is a, you're right, it is none of these. And so it's a typo. And this is, it should have been 0.032. And so you would have to do like F, answer F, 0.032 or something like that. And if you see something like that, you can come up and check with me that you're sure you did this correctly and the answer's not there. That happens, not just here, but it also happens on our textbook. There's some homework problems in which the solutions manual has the wrong answer. I have to look and see if they fixed that in the 11th edition. But I don't, I haven't checked it yet. Check it. All right, let's go on to 9. This, when the concentration of the products increases, delta G, if this increases, this is going to be bigger, delta G would. If you have more product, what do you think? Bigger driving force or smaller driving force? Concentration. Big. Bigger delta G, smaller driving force. So A increases. Number 10 is very similar to the problem we did. Worksheet in class. Did anybody get the answer for this one? The number? There are multiple ways of doing this. You could use the equation I gave you yesterday too, but let's look it up. Point 0.123 bar. Is that what you guys got? 0.123 bar is correct. Did somebody get the temperature for this? Number 11? Yeah. That was on the homework, and that was the problem we did yesterday. You just follow the exact same format as what we did yesterday, or as you do on the homework. And so that's number 11. All right, so the format's going to be similar. You know, you're going to have some multiple choice. It's just going to be one page. Multiple choice and some other problems here. Calculations. Some conceptual. All right, any other questions?
Okay, there are no other questions. I'm going to take a look at chapter 15.
Here, we'll look at some of the ICE style stoichiometry calculations.
So there are different ways of determining K. We can determine K from thermodynamics, or we can determine K from experiment. And so let's take a look at determining K from experiment. Determining K from experiment is just measuring the equilibrium concentrations. You let the reaction go and you measure the equilibrium concentrations and then take the ratio. That's pretty much it. And so, initially, when chapter 15 starts out, we have writing equilibrium constant expressions like Kc or Kp. Kc would just be the ratio of the concentrations raised to the respective coefficients. Kp would just be the partial pressures raised to the coefficients. And so, this is just figuring out the ratios here. The first two problems here are just testing, do you know nomenclature? You know, can you write the correct formulas for these things and balance the equation? You have to have a balanced equation to get the right coefficients. The next series are here, you know, we're doing Kc's. Reactions are already given here. Well, here we have some heterogeneous ones where we have solids. Solids we don't include in the Kc expression. Here, Kp, and here we have solids as well. But everything else is gases here, everything else is solutions here. And then we continue on, and then we'll see, you'll see mix, you know, what happens if you have a gas and a solution. If you have a gas and a solution, then we have Keq. But so far we have Kc's and Kp's. Okay, now, there's different ways we can determine Kc values, and one of the ways is something similar to Hess's law. And so let's take a look at like this problem here. Let's say we want the K value for this reaction. We could go ahead and measure experimentally what the equilibrium concentrations or the equilibrium pressures are, whichever is easier to measure, usually pressures for gases. But we don't have to do any experimental work if we have some existing data. And so if we see we have the existing data here, we have reactions that we could potentially add up like Hess's law to get this one. Then what we do is, unlike Hess's law where you add the energies, we multiply the Ks here. And so if we want the Kc for this one, all we do is we look for a reaction which has N2O, nitrous oxide on one side. Here's nitrous oxide. Except it's the reverse, you know. This is N2O as a product, this is N2O as a reactant. So if we flip this backwards, what do we do with K? Now with energy and Hess's law, we multiply it by a negative sign. But for Ks, we have to invert it, because if we flip it backwards, the ratio changes. What was once product is now reactant, and what was once reactant is now product, so we got to flip it. And so if we invert this, we take 1 over that, then we have nitrous oxide. And so we had one, well actually we need 2 moles. And so we'll have to reverse this, okay, invert that, and we have to multiply by 2 to get 2 moles of nitrous oxide. To get 2 moles of nitrous oxide, what we do is we double all the concentration. If we double everything, what the net result is we have to square this. And so we square that in Kc term. And so, that gives us 2 nitrous oxides, and then we ignore the rest. The rest should cancel out if things go well. And then we have O2. We need 3 moles of O2. This has O2 here as a reactant, so we'll just use this. This also does, but if we use this, then it'll cancel out the nitrous oxide. We don't want that to happen. And so here we have our O2. We just multiply this one by 3. If we multiply this one by 3, what do we do to Kc here? We multiply by 3 or we cube it? We're going to cube it. And so this would be cubed here. And then that gets 3 O2s. And then we need two N2O4s here. We have N2O4 here. What we'll do is we'll reverse that and double it, which means squaring this. And that's all we do. And everything else should work out or cancel out. And so do that here. And so let me just set up the first equation. So what we did was we did this. We took two N2Os. This is going to give us two N2s plus an O2. And then what we did with the K, this is where we're going to go KC1. And so we reversed it, and we doubled it. And so that's what we have here. And so this new K is just 1 over KC1 squared. Okay, that takes care of the N2Os. Then we want 3 O2s. So what we did was we multiplied this one. So we got 3 halves, an N2 plus 3 O2s yields 3 NO2s. And so this is KC3. We're going to cube that. And then we'll go with the N2O4's product. So we're going to reverse it and double it. And so if we reverse it and double it, we get 4 NO2s. This is going to give us 2 N2O4s. So we reversed it. That's KC2. We'll invert it and then double it. We do that. Now add these up and see, does everything else cancel out? So what's the net? If you were to add these up like Hess's law, what's the net on there?
did it add up?
So what you're looking for is did it add up or not? And so when we do this, let's take a look at what happens here. So we have three halves and two here, and two and two here. So this is 1.5 and two. And so this is going to give me 1/2 an N2 here. And then I have an O2 here and three O2s here. So this is going to give me two O2s there. And then I have three NO2s here and then four NO2s here. So that's going to give me one NO2 there. Now, is this the reaction that I want here? No, because when I add these up, I'm going to get two N2Os plus an NO2 plus two O2s. Actually, I forgot those here. This is going to give me 1/2 N2. And what did I get? Plus two N2O4s. Is that right? And so two NO2s plus two O2s plus an NO2, unless I made some mistake, let me just make sure it's still balanced. So you have five nitrogens, yeah, it's still balanced. And so did it work out? No, it didn't quite work out. Normally it should work out, but it must have. The second one by four?
Yeah.
Why did I multiply by three? I multiplied by three because the second one, this one, I multiplied by three because I wanted the three O2s here. Yeah, that's true. I have O2 on the other one, so I didn't. And so let me just double check this here. I mean, we could, but let's see why it didn't work out. And so two N2Os. Two N2s and an O2. So we want the two N2Os. And I wanted the O2s. So I got three O2s, 3/2 N2 plus three NO2s. And then I wanted the N2O4s, the two N2O4s on the back. So that's, oh, I see what I did. Do you see what I did? I guess I don't see what I did. Two N2O4s here, and then four NO2s here. And then cancel, 1.5, 1/2, three. I didn't want the O2s to cancel, you're right, because that O2 screws it up there. And so I need one more equation to do that. And so if I add, let's see, I gotta get rid of the NO2 here. And so you're right, I should have multiplied this by four, but I didn't see that. And so what we'll do is we'll do it here. I gotta get rid of an NO2, so let's get rid of that. So I got NO2 here, and then I have two equations that can get rid of NO2. I have this one and this one here, but I want to use that one. And so if I get rid of the NO2 here, sorry, I've done this problem before, but I don't know why I'm not seeing it here, but NO2, we'll cancel that. And then I want one NO2, and so this, I have to have 1/2 N2 here plus an O2, and then I'm going to have to add a KC3 to this. And then let's see what we got here. The 1/2 N2 cancels, the O2s add up, and the NO2s cancel. And so I end up with 2 N2Os plus 3 O2s. This is going to yield 2 N2O4s. And all together, what I'll have to do is K for this is going to be, rather than adding these, we're just going to multiply them. And so I'm going to have 1 over KC1 squared times KC3 cubed times 1 over KC2 squared times KC3. And then I'll just plug in the numbers here. And so let's go ahead and plug in the numbers for this. KC1 is 2.7 times 10 to the minus 18. Let's do that here. 2.7 times 10 to the minus 18 squared, invert, times KC3. And 4.1 times 10 to the minus 9 cubed. Okay. Divided by KC2 squared. So 4.6 times 10 to the minus 3. Actually, this doesn't handle scientific notation very well. So I've got to use parentheses. Did somebody calculate it? Well, basically, you'll just plug in the numbers. The rest will be algebra. So you can just calculate that. And so the basic strategy is you just do it like Hess's law. So it's very similar to Hess's law. The only difference is what you do when you reverse it and when you multiply. When you reverse it, we invert it. When we multiply by coefficient, we have to raise it to that power rather than multiplying to delta H to that power. And so that's one way of getting K without actually having to do an experiment. You can do it that way. The other way of getting it is just do the experiment. And so number 17 just shows getting K doing the experiment. Let's do, let's see, 17. We'll do number 18. Okay, for number 18, if we don't have data that we can use to determine K by Hess's law type problem, what we can do is we do this. We start off with a mixture of 1.00 grams of hydrogen and 1.06 grams of H2S in a 0.500 liter flask. And so we can figure out how much we have. What they want us to do is bring this to equilibrium. And so we have some kind of reaction occur, and then this is at the end of the reaction. At the end of the reaction, the quantity of chlorine present at equilibrium is found to be, so we'll have Cl2 gas, it's going to be 9.65 times 10 to the minus 4 moles. Okay, it's still a 0.500 liter flask. Oops, no, I read the wrong one, sorry. 8.00. This is going to be the quantity of S2 gas is 8.00 times 10 to the minus 6 moles. Okay, determine the value of Kp. And so they want us to figure out what the equilibrium ratio is. And so what we'll do is we'll take a look at the reaction. 2H2 gas plus S2 gas is going to be in equilibrium with 2H2S gas.
And so initially I have 1.00 grams of hydrogen and 1.06 grams of H2S. How many grams of S2 do I have? It turns out I'll have 0 grams of S2 present at equilibrium. Now, we can't leave it in terms of grams because the ice table is only going to be in terms of concentration or pressure. And so we can't even leave it in terms of moles. We'll have to do molarity or bar. So which one do you prefer, molarity or bar? Well, this is a KP. This one is a KC. So this one we do in molarity. They give us a mole, so we'd have to convert from moles to moles per liter. So we have the volume here to do that. This one they're asking for KP, so probably the easiest is just to go ahead and put it in atmospheres or bars. We'll just put it in bars initially. And so what we want to do is we want the initial pressure in bars. And so we'll have to calculate the pressure, the hydrogen, first. And the pressure is just equal to nRT over V. And so we have 1.00 grams, and then we'll just convert grams into moles. So a mole of hydrogen is 2.016 grams of hydrogen. So we got moles. And then R, I just know the R for atmosphere. So this is liters atmosphere per mole Kelvin. I don't know the R for bars. I could calculate it and memorize it, but I'm not. I probably should. But I know this one. I know how many bar are in an atmosphere. There's 1.01325 bar in an atmosphere. And so the R constant in bar is very close. And then T, the temperature that's given is 1670 Kelvin. So I'll do 1670 Kelvin here. Divided by V, the volume, 500 liters.
So let's go ahead and calculate this.
Actually, can you calculate the pressures of the hydrogen and the H2S?
For me?